The time of preparation. Father Beppino Puttinato was born in Baricetta, a village close to Rovigo in the northeast of Italy, on 7th April 1933. Since young age, he discovered his vocation to become a missionary priest. He studied in the diocesan minor seminary of Rovigo from 46 to 54. And then in the novitiate of France from 54 to 56. He completed his theological studies in Venegono, close to Milan, from 56 to 59, and was ordained a priest on the 14th of March 1959 by the Archbishop of Milan, who would later become Pope, St. Paul VI. At that time he was 26 years old and just could speak Italian language. He immediately was sent to Sudan to work at Comboni College, Khartoum. 1979, missionary teacher at Comboni College, Khartoum. Father Pino defined his service this time as the one of a missionary teacher. He was a missionary, as he had been sent, and this is the meaning of the word, to serve people as Jesus did. And his first service was to take care of the boarders who come from different points of Sudan to study at Comboni College. Those years were not easy, as he was not able to communicate with them. He even felt the temptation of leaving. But he persevered, and he studied English language with great commitment. In fact, with the passing of time, his knowledge of the language became so outstanding that he would correct the best teachers. In fact, he would become a teacher of English, history and religion at Comboni College, Khartoum. 1989-81, interval in Lebanon. After 20 years of missionary teaching service at CCK, he was sent to Lebanon for a sabbatical period. There, he had the opportunity to study Arabic. But the environment was not too helpful. The continuous bombardments because of the war between Syria and Israel obliged people to remain in isolation. 81-87, St. Augustine Minor Seminary in Khartoum. As we returned to Khartoum, the new Archbishop of Khartoum, Gabriel Zubair Wako, asked him to organize a secondary course for seminarians who were over age. The Lord be with 87-92, Comboni Secondary School in Port Sudan. In 87 he was sent to Port Sudan. He described his service at the Comboni Secondary School of that city as the most gratifying experience of his journey as educator because of the extraordinary relation with teachers, students, mainly Eritrean refugees, parents, and the Australian and Egyptian volunteers. For these volunteers he built a house which is now the house where the missionaries of charity live. One of those students, Nadia Abdallah Idris, remembers her days at the school in those years. Looking back at those happy days, yes, they were really happy days, I must say that I learned a lot in my Comboni school. Particularly, I learned the meaning of tolerance in its true form. There at Comboni, we were a mixture of races, cultures and religions, and we shared the same desks, the same notes and books. In my school, I experienced the joy of sharing. 92-2001, UCCK. The new government of Omar al-Bashir changed the educational laws. Foreigners could no longer be headmasters. Thus, Father Bepinno became counselor of the primary and the secondary sections of Comboni College, Khartoum. Charles Youssef, a Maltese student and later on teacher at CCK, today lecturer at the University of Malta, recalls those years. When I look back at CCK, and surely also at the University College, I see a lot of positive differences from other colleges and universities besides, of course, the financial part. It is there that we learned how to care for others, to love and forgive, to live in harmony and share our belongings and talents. The school was not only an educational institution, but a lifelong learning process that taught us more than words, numbers and ideologies. Therefore, what defines a Comboni graduate is not only his social, poor class, but one's ability to look at the world with a different lens that does not see color, religion or political orientation, but only focuses on the human dignity and on the fact that we are all adopted sons and daughters of the only and one God. 94 Colta. In 1994, Father Bepinno started Colta, Lay Teachers Association, with the aim of caring for the spiritual growth of Catholic teachers who worked at CCK and other schools. 2001, founder of Comboni College of Science and Technology. In 1999, some parents and teachers of the basic section of Comboni College asked Father Bepinno, why doesn't Comboni develop into a university, as Gordon College and other secondary schools in Khartoum have become universities? Father Bepinno was already 66 years old, but he was ready to start such a great new project. With the help of Dr. Abdallah Khalil, Dr. Nahla Jaafar, Mr. John Rubain and other Sudanese friends, and the support of the Archbishop and the provincial superior of the Comboni missionaries at the time, Father Salvatore Pacifico, what looked impossible became a reality. We had to consider that in those years the government of Sudan was strongly applying the Islamic law and that the applicant was a church institution. Father Bepinno used to say that the gestation period of a human being is 9 months, that of an ass is 1 year, that of an Indian elephant is 2 years. Also that of Comboni College of Science and Technology was 2 years. Does that mean that our college is destined to be an elephant? On the 5th of April 2001, the Ministry of Higher Education and Scientific Research of Sudan approved Comboni College of Science and Technology with an initial Bachelor of Science in Computer Science. In the following years, 2 diplomas in Information Technology, Accounting and Business Administration, a BA in English Language and Literature, and a Bachelor of Science in Information Technology followed. Ian Sudanese and Merciful. The President of the Republic of Sudan granted Father Bepinno Sudanese nationality in 2003, and the Gold Medal of the Order of Sciences and Arts in 2005 to recognize his contribution to the education of thousands of Sudanese and refugee persons. On the other hand, his home country, Italy, also recognized his service as he was granted the Knighthood of the Order of the Star of Italian Charity by the President of the Republic of Italy in 2004. But surely, in front of God, the warmest recognition comes from the thousands of persons Father Bepinno supported to complete their education, to pay medical operations, to pay the house rent. His works of mercy are uncountable. In fact, one of his many Sudanese Muslim friends would say to him, Father, when I see you, when I think of you, I am reminded of God. Last days. Last August 2020, his health condition started deteriorating. There were some kidney stones and an infection. At a certain moment, one of the doctors suggested taking him to Italy for further checkup. At the beginning he was reluctant, but as he was getting weaker and weaker, he himself wished to be taken for further checkups with the hope of finding the treatment that would strengthen him to continue his service back in Khartoum. After some weeks in Castel Dano, COVID-19 invaded that community and took advantage of the weak condition of his body. Over the last 1 week, has claimed the lives of Father six confrères in that same community. Father Bepinno was a man of few words, sometimes few. The Lord called him to himself on a Sunday, in which he tells us that the gospel is really simple. I was hungry and you gave me food, thirsty and you gave me to drink. But he passed away on Sunday, 22nd of November, Trinity of Christ the King, 1:30 a.m. May Father Bepinno rest in peace.